Today I'm looking at firmware 8.0, which has just been released this week for the Garmin Edge 1030, the most significant update and feature set addition added to this unit since release. Earlier in 2019, with the release of the 830 and the 530, Garmin promised that the 1030, which is 2 years old now, would receive a lot of those updates and features that come with those newer units, such as ClimbPro, mountain bike metrics, and a ton of other stuff. Well, that firmware has been in test for a long time in beta, and it's finally here in public. Let's go through the feature set. Over here on the Garmin website, it does say September 11th was the release date for this public firmware. So if you've checked lately and it's not there, that's probably because you were caught up in the slow rollout of this. I waited all weekend. I didn't get it. I had to grab the firmware from somewhere else. But it is now at 100% rollout as of September 17th, 2019. And the other thing to note with this changelog is it's all additional features or updates. It's not fixed, fixes, which is typically what we see with Garmin firmware. But these are all new features stacked to the brim. Let's have a quick scan of what's new. We can see here this pretty much does bring it up to the 830, 530 level of features. So training load focus, two-way setting syncs, acclimations in there. ClimbPro is now added to the public release. We had a quick look at that with the beta release the other day, but ClimbPro is now public in this release. Nutrition and hydration tracking, workout comparison, widget management, bike theft alarm, find my edge, grip flow and jump metrics for the mountain bikers. And jumping down to the bottom there, they reordered the settings to match the Edge 830, splitting the growing number of settings into safety tracking, incident detection, get assistance, connected features, etc. I think what they're doing there is they're trying to unify the user experience or the UI interface with the 530, 830, and now the 1030. So if you're familiar with configuring this and you move to one of these, happy days, easy done, or vice versa. So just unifying that user experience, which I think is important these days, especially how complex these things are getting. Okay, there's the details. I'll link below to that full list, but let's get it installed on this unit here. I have two of these in Llama Lab and I've been out testing with this one. This one hasn't been updated. Let's get to it now. Okay, the Edge 1030 that doesn't have the new firmware. You can see it has my little startup logo we put on there the other day. Should request to install. So I've had 787 beta firmware on there. It now wants to install version 8 public. Estimated install time 2 minutes. Let's get that done on this unit. That's suboptimal. Okay, it was transferring data, so I think that's what took place there. It was syncing data from the cloud, from Garmin Connect, but, well, such is not live television. Okay, the download failed up there was the syncing of data, so this should be fine. It didn't happen on this other unit, that's okay. Okay, that should now boot up and install. There we go, preparing update. Loading software. Update complete. Happy days. Loading courses and workouts. Opens the maps. Easy as that. We are done. We will just go and verify that on the menus system. About. No software update, but if we do go to copyright info, it should tell us everything here. So software version 8.0, GPS version 0. Okay. Everything else looks okay. The GPS version concerns me. We might do a final reboot just to be sure. It's doing a transfer of something. It is on my Wi-Fi. We'll wait for the transfer to finish. Just in case it's pulling down a GPS chipset update. While that takes place, I will show you the ClimbPro stuff on here, which I've been using. This is my wife's unit. That's why I have two. Hang on. Let me just, yep. Let me have it right. Oh, that should read property of Mrs. Llama too. Okay. You're in the naughty corner. Download complete. So it's done something over there. So navigation, courses, saved courses, and today I did a Buninyong climb using ClimbPro. And so summary, map, elevation. Now we have climbs listed on here. You can see there, there's two climbs, that meet the ClimbPro criteria, which there's three of those. We'll do ClimbPro in another video, but just as a quick summary, I'll show you what that's about. So you can see the one main climb there from outside of Buninyong up to the top, with average gradient of 4%. And the second climb there is in town, average grade of 8% at 513 meters. And there are the two climbs. Let's have a look at that in action out on the road. Okay, a few kilometers down the road on my ride, 12.14 kilometers to be precise. Now scrolling through the screens here with the D-Fly buttons that I have set up on my DI2. Next, there we go. Now the screen here, you can see I'm 2.11 kilometers away from climb number one. Average gradient of 4%. Climb number two, which is still 30 kilometers down the road. Back to climb number one. Okay, so you can see it counting down to the start of the climb there. And just about at the start of the climb, well, 83 meters from the start of the climb there, it tells you that it's coming up, and then it pops up on the screen there with all the details. 9.02 kilometers to go to the top of that climb, I think, and it's detected the car with my radar. Okay, halfway up the climb here, it's hard to hang onto the camera and ride with it, so I've got a still shot here. You can see here, halfway up the climb, it's reading 0% grade because I am stopped, but it gives you some running information. And speaking of running information or riding information, here's my attempt at trying to show you the steepest part of the climb with a glossy screen. Now the gloss screen doesn't work too well here, but I'm including this in the video to prove that I did ride up the steepest part of this climb. You can just see the information pop. No, I'm just going to give up. Let's just ride the climb and get it done. So there's a quick overview of what that looks like out on the road when you hit go and navigate. It's not too bad at all, but we will cover ClimbPro in another video. But now, back from the naughty corner, this one here with the GPS firmware set to 0.0. Let's try and troubleshoot that. So I'm going to do a hard off. And my go-to method to make sure everything is properly synced is to use Garmin Express with a USB cable. So I'll do that later on if this doesn't work, but I thought we'll just go through this as a bit of troubleshooting. Didn't seem to do anything there. System. About. Copyright info. Okay, that's for later on. Okay, that one aside, I'll look into that later. We've seen ClimbPro work on this unit out on the road just briefly. Let's have a look at the bike alarm setting that now comes with this new firmware. So the setting of bike alarm is within safety and tracking and bike alarm down here. Now I've already set a passcode. I think I know what the passcode is. Let's have a look at setting that off. So let's just say you're doing an well, no one's going to steal your bike indoors, you'd hope, if you're out in the road. But the way to get that, straight down from the top, over to the side here, and set bike alarm. Activating 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Alrighty, so that's now alarmed. And you can see on my watch, bike alarm is now on. And it may also bike alarm on my phone too. There we go, your bike has been armed. Now, let's just say someone steals your bike. Whoa, look out. Bang, the alarm has been triggered over here too. So your phone's notified. That's chirping away like a bird on acid. To turn alarm off. Put in my secret code and the GPS firmware has updated successfully. Well, I'd like to thank the bicycle alarm for updating my GPS firmware. Nothing ever goes to plan. Let's have a look at that. Oh, happy days. There we go. So if your GPS version is set to 0.0, set your bike alarm and happy day. That's not really what happens. That's just what went on. Oh, also, my watch had notified me that the bike alarm had gone off. So if you don't get the alert to your phone and your watch is in range, this goes off. Everything within the Garmin ecosystem chirps away. Cool. Okay, we'll leave it there. There's a quick look at some of the new features. So there we are, firmware 8.0 for the Edge 1030, which really does bring it up to almost this level with all those additional features. Now, it is a two-year-old device. You're not going to get the same kind of menu speeds and things out of it, but they've done pretty well jam-packing all those new features into an older unit. Not bad at all. I always say units and devices are only ever one firmware update away from being a better experience, And that was out on the road today. Good stuff. All right, links below to all this information. Do your updates. Enjoy the ride. Thanks for watching.